Good morning, and welcome to today's edition of Stephen Whiteside's Stock Market Timing Television. Each day at this time, Stephen takes a technical look at the markets, including the S&P 500, NASDAQ, gold, crude oil, as well as the most widely held leveraged ETFs. This video is a production of TheUptrend.com and is for information and educational purposes only. The views and opinions expressed in this presentation are those of Stephen Whiteside and should not be considered personal investment advice. Always consult a qualified financial advisor before making any investment decisions. To learn more about the charts featured in this presentation, please visit TheUptrend.com. And now, here is Stephen Whiteside with today's video newsletter.
Good morning, Steve Whiteside here with your daily market outlook for Thursday, January 28th, 2010. In the pre-market this morning, we've got futures up above fair value, but they've firmed up a bit over the past hour or so, so I'm a little more confident that we're going to see a higher open at 9:30 on Thursday morning. Now, we've been watching the major indexes. They've rolled over the past couple of weeks, certainly not to the extent that they have in other places in the world, but that's the thing. The rest of the world, these emerging markets, the Chinese market, all these places that we're expecting to help grow the global economy, those stock markets are falling off a cliff. And so when we're watching the ETFs, or whether it's the emerging markets, or this is a Claymore for the BRIC, we can see we're down not only testing the October lows, but in a lot of cases penetrating them. So we need to keep an eye on this, the fact that the markets around the world are continuing to deteriorate. Reversal yesterday, but at the same time, certainly no new uptrends for these markets. And I believe that that's going to continue to put pressure on the North American markets going forward. Now, one stock not doing well on the global stage, of course, is Toyota. We broke down through the flypaper channel. That's certainly bearish. And of course, we do have a lot of support just below where we are right now. So this is still a $70 stock. And we're expecting lots of support down there at 73. And then if 73 breaks, we've got some open gaps over on the left-hand side down in the 60s that could be possible downside targets for Toyota going forward. Now, Nokia reported better than expected results this morning. And if the stock closes where it's trading right now in Europe, we'd get a new daily buy signal with a daily close above 1320. Now, Nokia's been doing pretty good the last couple of months. It's after a big drop, it's stabilized, while Motorola has continued to move lower. A daily close above 760 on Thursday would give us a buy signal for Motorola. Now, 3M is reporting better than expected results this morning. Stocks up in the pre-market. A daily close above 84 would give us a buy signal. At this point, all I'd be willing to do is close my short position. We're up at the top of the panic zones. There's no pressure zone at the bottom of the screen. Taking a trade on 3M right now would certainly not be a low-risk opportunity. And it's something that I would just wave off and continue to look for other opportunities. Now, Procter & Gamble is reporting today better than expected results. Last time I looked, it was up in the pre-market. And daily close above 61.10 would give us a buy signal for Procter & Gamble. Apple Computer still treading water. It's in between 200 and 212.50, right in the middle. We had earnings out. We had the new iPhone iPod come out yesterday. The iPod Whopper came out, and we're still trading in that range. So a breakout above 212 takes us to 225. A breakdown below 200 takes us to 187.50. Now, some of the other stocks I follow, CME Group reversed yesterday. Certainly didn't take out the previous day's high, so no chance of a buy signal. Google is very interesting. Been treading water the last few days. We're certainly building support right along that level. I would imagine that if we break that support, that Google's going to go down sharply from here. Goldman Sachs made a lower low yesterday, but recovered going into the close. Research in Motion, if Nokia is going higher on Thursday, that could help help Research in Motion go higher. A daily close above 65 would give us a buy signal on Thursday. Bank stocks really shot up yesterday. That's one of the reasons that the markets recovered going into the close. So we're still on a sell signal for bank stocks, but certainly up at the top of the channel. And a higher close on Thursday would give us a new buy signal. Looking at gold stocks, they're certainly penetrating those October lows at the present time. The U.S. dollar was interesting to see. The U.S. dollar, we had this previous high. We've not only been able to trade above it, which has happened before, but we actually closed above it. So a breakout above 79 on Thursday takes us up to 80. Taking a look at the 60-minute charts for Thursday's trading activity, the S&P 500, we've been down at the bottom of the panic zones. We've got a nice big pressure zone forming here. So we are projecting higher prices at the moment. At the same time, we've got an hourly flypaper channel, which is up in the 115-120 area, centered around 1117. And so we're looking for any rally to get capped out in that area. At the same time, that's no guarantee that we're going to move from where we are right now up into that area. And once again, as happened yesterday and the day before that, if we don't test those areas, then this hourly flypaper channel is going to continue to move lower. And this time tomorrow, it'll probably be down below the 1115 area. Now, we're on an hourly buy signal as of the close on Wednesday. And so as long as we remain above 1090 on an hourly basis on Thursday, we can remain bullish on the S&P 500 cash index. Now, at the same time, as long as the VIX keeps moving lower and doesn't start trading above 2480, we can remain bullish on the S&P 500. Looking at the NASDAQ, we can remain bullish on Thursday as long as we don't start closing below 1800. On the SOX index, we can remain bullish as long as we don't start closing below 333. And for gold stocks, we still need to get over 156 on an hourly basis before we can start to get bullish on gold stocks on Thursday. Okay, that's all for Thursday morning, folks. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again on Friday morning.
That was Stephen Whiteside with today's edition of Stock Market Timing Television. For more information on our charts and services, please visit theuptrend.com.